Greetings for the day. My name is Muhammad Rahmat Ali. Welcome to another session of Computer Networks. In today's session, we are going to learn about the socket address and the different types of elementary sockets and what are the different elementary sockets and how it has been implemented in computer networks. But before jumping into the topic, let me remind what are the things that we have studied in the previous session. We studied with reference to the socket programming. We studied about why sockets are being used, where sockets are being used, how sockets are being used. In today's session, we are going to learn about what actually is socket address and what are the elementary sockets. Okay, and also we are going to see the different methods that has been involved in sockets to make a communication between a client and a server. And hereby, by the mean client and server doesn't mean any of the mainframe type of things. It can be your own system acting as a server and your own system acting as a client. Client and server is something like which exchange information based on request. You send requests, you will be getting a response. These type of communication is called as client-server type of a communication. Now, what actually is a socket address? An application can communicate with a remote process by exchanging data with TCP/IP by knowing the combination of protocol type, IP address, and port number. This combination is often known as socket address. Now, what do you mean by a socket that I have told you in the last one? An external node that acts as a taking of an input and sending of an input is called as a socket. Now, if I tell you something like this, my name is Ali, I stay in Hyderabad. If at all someone asks me where exactly in Hyderabad, then I'll tell him the address, my location, my landmark, or from where he can or she can come. So it means I am giving some of the protocol type, IP address, and port number. So all of these three things is called as socket address. In the same way as I have given my location, door number, landmark, and the way to come. This will help the person to reach me out. In the same way with reference to sockets, the sockets will give the protocol type used and the IP address been used, and which port number. All of this combination is called as a socket address. Now, why socket address has been used? For instance, I want to, as I am delivering a lecture now, or else I am giving a presentation to you, someone is making some noise, for instance, taking an example, then I'll particularly address that particular person to make him aware that you are disturbing or you are making some noise during a session. So at this instance, with reference to all of these connections being made, I am particularly addressing one particular person to communicate some information. So in the same way, with reference to socket address, a network want to deliver some packets or deliver some information or pass some information on one particular address, then at that instance, socket address will be taken into consideration. But because it has protocol type, it has IP address, also it has port number. Also, it has port number to get communicated. Now, further what it says, it is a network-facing access handle to the network socket. The remote process establishes a network socket in its own instance of protocol stack and uses the networking API to connect to the application presenting its own socket address by the use of application or by the application. Now, what do you mean by API? API stands for Application Programming Interface, which helps in making understand what we are trying to speak with reference to the the referency or to the audience. For an instance, you have APIs in your mobile phones. Now, what actually API does, or you have some APIs with reference on your desktop on your laptop, what actually they does? They help us in communicating the information. For instance, I want to hear an audio clip. So what is the API that I am using? I'll be using window media player. If at all, if I want to watch a video as well as listen a voice, at that instance, I'll be using VLC player. It means they are the mediator which is helping me to access that particular information, with the help of that API. In the same way, to access a remote process or to access a remote process or to establish a remote process network, we'll be using a protocol stack with reference to network APIs to get communicated to that particular network instance. Now, I'll tell you a small example with reference to, your college. For an instance, let me consider you are studying in a college. As you want to get graduated, you want to get a job. So what people of college will do, they will call some of the companies for campus placements. So that after you getting graduated or within your study period, you will get a job or an internship so that you can improve your skills. You need not go anywhere external place to get a job. You need not go to some other place so that you will be there as an individual entity. But the college is acting as an API to get connected to the job for you. So this is what we call as an API. It will help you in communicating with reference to other remote places. In the same way, with reference to socket, this will help you to communicate with other networks in exchanging the information and to transfer the packets from one network to another network based on IP address, based on the port numbers and type of protocol that is being used. And also, if you remember, in the previous session, we started about with reference to protocols, two different protocols are being used, then we'll be using tunneling type of thing so that they both can be communicated with another. Now, with reference to the socket address will help you to communicate with pinpoint location so that the information that is being processed from source will reach the destination with all of its values without any delay, without any losing of packets, and in complete form. Now, moving forward, what are the elementary sockets? What are the different elementary sockets with reference to the TCP/IP? With reference to TCP/IP, in the sense, what is actually the implementation of socket being done with reference to the TCP/IP or with reference to communication? The first function that is being used is connect. Now, what this connect will do? This connect function is used by a TCP client to establish a connection with a TCP server. Now, this connect function will help us, will help the client to establish a connection with reference to the server. For an instance, you are opening your email, like for example, Gmail is there, and simultaneously you want to access Yahoo also. So what you will be doing, as you are connected to the Gmail, you also want to get connection with the Yahoo. So what Yahoo server will do, the Yahoo server will open its ports so that if anyone, the clients want to connect to that server, it will give the connection. Now how it will give the connection, we are going to see in the coming part of the slides. Now what actually the connect function will do, or the connect method will do, the connect function is used by a TCP client to establish a connection with a TCP server. Now, don't get confused. This is just to represent how it will be. Now, what it is here, hash include system type or hash include these things. What it is, int connect. We are passing some of the values. What are the values that is in pass? Socket ID and socket address with reference to the server address and the address length that we are going to send. This is just a general syntax or format to connect with reference to the server from the client. This call return 0 if it is successfully connected, otherwise will return -1 on errors. If at all nothing is there, you will not be given any of the access to that particular website or with reference to the particular website that you want to access. Now the second type of function is the bind. Now what this function will do, the bind function assigns a local protocol address to a socket with the internet protocols. The protocol address in the combination of either 32-bit in IPv4 address or 128-bit in IPv6 address along with a 16-bit TCP or UDP port number. This function is called by TCP server only. Now, what actually do you mean by this? Like, this looks very difficult with reference to the, like, you know, difficult word that is when you use like 128-bit, 32-bit, UDPs, TCP, 16-bit, XYZ type of things. This is very simple. How it is simple? It is simple in this way. You requested for something and server is responding to you with reference to its own format. What is the format? 32-bit is a format with reference to IPv4. 128-bit is a format for IPv6 along with the 16-bit of TCP or UDP port number. Now what do you, like, why, if at all, like, you know, you are from this particular college and another guy from another XYZ college comes to our college, can he be admitted in the class? No, he is not admitted in the class until and unless he has got some special permission or special privilege type of access. So when we are addressing, what is the addressing format? He should be from engineering. And what is the special thing that we are telling? The special permission that has been given to that particular packet to enter that particular network. This is one part. Another part is, for an instance, like this should not happen, but for an example I'm telling you, there is one student who has failed in first year as well as who has failed in second year. Will he be promoted to third year? No, he will not be promoted to third year until and unless he clears first and second year. Though he is from same college, though he is studying along with friends, but he is not been allowed in fifth semester or third year. Why? Because he's not able to pass the particular subjects. In the same way, when a 32-bit of address is been given, along with that 16-bit of TCP or UDP port number is been given, so that who is requesting for that particular information is been sent over here, so that server and client can be bind together, so that they can transfer the information or they can interchange some of the values so that they can interchange the data packets. So this is what we called as bind function, sorry. Now, moving forward, the next function is the listen function. Now, what this listen function will do? This listen function is called only by a TCP server and it has been performed two actions. The first action is, the listen function converts an unconnected socket into a passive socket, indicating that the kernel should accept incoming connection requests directed to this socket. What is the second one? The second one is, or like before going to second one, what this listen function will do is, like, if at all if there is any of the free port that is been available, it can accept that particular connection is been the first point. If at all is there any of the free connection that has been available and there is a client who is requesting for that particular server, now for that particular client and to that particular server, the connection can be given is been set in the first point. I repeat, the listen function converts an unconnected socket into a passive socket, indicating that the kernel should accept incoming connection requests directed to this socket. What is the second point? The second point says, the second argument to this function specifies the maximum number of connections the kernel should queue for this socket. For an instance, there are 10 sockets that have been opened and there are 10 connections been coming as a request. Now, the 11th connection that is been requesting will be set into queue so that the first or second or third or any of the connections finishes, this can be given the request. This can be given the request. This is the second point. This is the second point. What was the first point? The first point says, if there is any of the free port, then give it to the connection. If at all, second point is, if at all there are some of the maximum, like the kernel should know what is the maximum connections that the server can give it, and what are the queues that can be there. Like if at all there are 10 connections, 100 connections cannot be in queue. There can be only 5 or 6 connections that can be in queue, so that after the first 10 connections get completed, these queue connections can complete their transactions. This is the second point. And the next function is the accept function. The next function is the accept function. What it says, the accept function is called by a TCP server to return the next completed connection from the front of the completed connection queue. This signature of the signature is called as something like this. Now what this say? This says the new connection which are in queue will be accepted after the previous connections or previous things are getting executed. Okay, the accept function is called only by TCP server and it returns the next completed connection. It will return the next completed connection so that new connections can be included in the queue or new connections can be included with reference to the transaction or in the TCP server. Now what is the next function? The next function is the send function. By the name it says, like, you know, sending the information. The send function is used to send data over a stream socket or a connected datagram socket. If you want to send data over unconnected datagram socket, you must use send to function. You must use send to function. Okay. Now, send function is used to send the information on the network. After the connection has been made, after the things has happened, then we can send the information from one side to another side. Either the client will be sending the information to the server or server will be sending the information to the client so that the communication can happen between those two systems. We can use write system call to send data. Its signature is as follows. This signature or general syntax, why it has been given? To get an idea how things will work. For that reason only, we are saying you or we are giving you this general syntax with reference to the different functions. Now, the next function is a receive function. This receive function will receive the values either from server or client. What it says, the receive function is used to receive data over a stream socket or connected datagram socket. If you want to receive data over unconnected datagram socket, you must use receive from. Okay, to make you better understand what actually this is, if at all if you remember, there was one application called as ShareIt. There was some application called as ShareIt, in which if at all if you want to send the data, you individually should set send. If you want to receive the data, you should say, I want to receive the data. If at all, if you are not at the receiver end, you should say receiver end so that you will get the connection from different type of different devices or different, places, so that you can receive the information from there. So to make you understand, I have given you an example. Don't write the same thing in the examination, okay? Now this receive function will receive. Once you are ready to receive, then you can receive the information. Or there can be some congestion with reference to sending and receiving. I can speak 10 words in 1 minute and you can understand only 5 words at 1 minute. So the 5 words that I am speaking extra, the 5 sentences that I am speaking extra will be over your head. You can understand 10 statements in one minute. I can speak only 5 statements in 1 minute. So this is not a proper communication. If at all, if I'm able to speak 5 statements, you should be able to understand 5 statements in 1 minute. Okay, If at all this happens, then the communication or conversation can be at a better level. So send and receive function is used to send the data and to receive the data over a stream socket connected. Now moving forward, the send to function is used to send function from, or like, you know, the send to function is used to send data over unconnected datagram socket so that there can be some connection between, to create a connection. And receive from is to make a connection for receiving of the information. Now the last function is the close function, which will help you in closing of the communication between client and server. So what it says, the close function is used to close the communication between client and server, and its syntax is as follows. Now what do you mean by this closing of connection? It is very much required to close a connection when you are starting with that connection so that no other person can intrude into that particular session. For instance, you went to a cyber cafe, you have entered your credentials for logging in Gmail address, and after that you didn't log out. It means that session is continuing, but for you that session is closed. But for Gmail, that session is continuing. There might be some intruder who can intrude into the Gmail address and can manipulate things. So for that reason, it is necessary to close the connection. What is the function that has been used? Close is the function that has been used to close the communication. Now, this is a pictorial representation of client and server with reference to TCP connection, with reference to receiving, binding, listening, or what you call as write, read, and close type of connections. This will help you. You can pause the video clip and you can see how the communication will take place from client to server and server to client. I hope you understood something from today's session. If at all, if you have any doubt, you can ping me or you can email me on my email address rahmat_ali2u@yahoo.com. If at all, if you have any of the doubts or if you want any of the material, you can email me. I'll provide you with a textbook which will help you in your preparation for your examination. If you want any of the additional material, you can come down to the college along with a memory device so that I can copy and give you the material. That's all for today. I hope all the best day for you. Hope to see you in the next session. Thank you for joining.